It's been almost 1 year since the initial fan vote for the LEGO Ideas 90th Anniversary Fan Chosen Set. Fans were given the ability to vote for what theme LEGO should bring back for one 2022 set. The plan was that the top three finishers, which were Bionicle, Classic Space, and Pirates, would then go on to another vote. But this was not the case in the end. In early February 2021, LEGO decided to change the rules last minute by adding in a fourth theme, that being Castle, which up until that point had been split between the various Castle sub-themes. Bionicle won the initial vote with ease, blowing the competition out of the water, with 6,000 more votes than Classic Space, the theme in second place. However, almost 1 year later, we still have no clue what the results of that second vote were. Sure, LEGO promised that the results of the second vote would not be transparent, but the fact that we're a year removed from the second vote and there has not even been a leak or any other sort of information about this set has got me worried. Leaks are constantly coming out about other themes. What's surprising to me is that all we have is complete radio silence on this 90th anniversary set. My theory, which many of you may find to be crazy, is that Bionicle won this fan vote, and that LEGO is really not happy about that. I mean, I can kind of understand where they're coming from if this is true. Bionicle G2 was a failure, and while we can debate whether LEGO or Bionicle fans are responsible for its demise, we can all agree that it was a complete fail nonetheless. However, this does not justify LEGO's anger or disappointment. If Bionicle won this vote fair and square, then it deserves one last hurrah. Whichever theme won the vote deserves to be brought back. One example that backs up this theory is LEGO's decision to have four themes compete in the second poll, as opposed to just three. Many LEGO fans that voted in this poll were not able to vote for their favorite theme, as a result of it losing the first vote. While we don't know what these non-Castle, Space, Pirates, or Bionicle fans chose to vote for instead, I have a hunch that they did not vote for Bionicle. After all, Bionicle has not been rebooted countless times over the years like these themes have, and it's a very niche theme. Competing with three other themes means that all non-Bionicle votes will be split across three themes, which is much better than Bionicle going up against only two themes, or worse comes to worse, only one. For example, if it was Bionicle versus Classic Space, all non-Bionicle voters would vote Space, and most likely defeat Bionicle. But with non-Bionicle fans having to choose between three themes, it gives Bionicle a chance to take the lead, as they are going up against three themes, which have split the anti-Bionicle vote up. In addition, the Bionicle fanbase is very strong, and has a huge online presence. Most fans had personal computers as children, and they are a part of the first generation that grew up alongside technology. While older Classic Space, Pirates, and Castle fans do know how to use the internet, I'm not calling them, you know, anti-technology boomers, I doubt that they even knew about this vote in the first place. Even if they did, I would be more surprised if they united online and made a whole campaign to win this election. Seeing the results of the first vote, Bionicle's 6,000 more votes than Classic Space only proves the strength of the Bionicle fanbase online. Bionicle fans will do anything in their power to give the theme a third generation, even if it is only for one set. Uniting online, getting family members to sign up and vote, and spreading the word are all things that they would be willing to do in order to win this election. They are dedicated, and they refuse to lose the 90th anniversary fan vote. Still though, even if Bionicle did win this vote, I could potentially see LEGO cancel this 90th anniversary set. We've already seen LEGO cancel their Marvel mechs, I know they're back now, but they did cancel them originally, and a holiday promo set this year. Well, last year. And public backlash did not alter their decision one bit. Maybe it did for the Marvel mechs, but for the holiday promo set, they didn't care. LEGO could easily either phase out this 90th anniversary set idea, edit the votes, or find another way to prevent a Bionicle set from coming out. The lack of leaks and other information only help them. If they decide to do away with this 90th anniversary set, they can easily do so in silence, as no one has talked about this set in months. Or if they decide to alter the votes and change the winner, they could also do that without problems, as there have been no leaks about this project whatsoever, meaning that if Bionicle won and LEGO didn't want it to win, they could easily pick Classic Space, and with no leaks, no one knows that Bionicle really won. Either way, I'm interested to see what happens with this situation. Let me know your thoughts down below. Be sure to like, comment, share especially, and subscribe, and I'll see you all next week.